You are welcome to the broadcast of the Living Word of Faith Outreach Ministries International. In this broadcast, join International Crusade and Conference Speaker, Teacher, Senior Pastor, Apostle, General Overseer and Presiding Prelate of the Living Word of Faith Outreach Ministries International, Bishop Akintayo Samjoli.
I announce to you, whatever was to follow you, that is not from God, it will not follow you, it will not follow your children.
His teachings and ministries have brought deliverance and transformation to many lives and families across the nation and beyond. Receive God's word with faith in your heart and watch your life move from glory to glory.
Good morning, and you are welcome to another devotional dawn service. And once again, I remind you to help someone get on this platform and be blessed. So please send out the link and let someone else be able to connect to the link and through you. Also, don't forget, if you're on Facebook, subscribe to it. Subscribe to subscribe to our YouTube broadcast and our YouTube page, so others can be, so you can be reminded each time we come on. But also, do not forget to like, share, comment on Facebook, and do things that will help others to be aware of this great blessing going on. We are talking about spiritual representatives, and we left off on our last broadcast looking at submission and the use of spiritual authority. God has given us spiritual authority to use and to represent Him in meeting the needs of people, in addressing situations in their lives, in ruling upon the face of the earth. And we see in James 4 verse 7, it says, submit yourselves therefore to God, resist the devil and he will flee from you. All the teachings, not all, I've had some teachings about the importance of worship, and I've taught on that, and the importance of being focused on God, and I've taught on that. But if God's word tells you to deal with an enemy, do not try to put forth, theories, scriptural theories, and how you don't need to deal with the devil. The Bible says resist the devil. And if he tells you to do it, simply do it. Don't be wiser than God, and don't follow all of these things that men are trying to put forth as their teachings and as their position. It says resist the devil and he'll flee from you. Failure to resist the devil would cause him to have an access point to cause trouble in your life and trouble in the lives of others. So, but the principle here is you can only have power, you can only exercise dominion over the devil when you are submitted to God. And to submit to God means to submit to the authority of His word, to submit to the established authorities, spiritual authorities they has put to watch over you. And of course, submitting to His word means submitting to the Holy Spirit as well. In Matthew 8 verse 8 and 9, it says, the centurion answered and said, Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only and my servant shall be healed. Alright, and then in verse 9, he tells why he's walking in such great faith and authority. He says, I am a man under authority. The reason why I can do this is because I'm under authority. And then when I'm under authority, I say to one, go, and he goes. To another, come, and he comes. A person who is not under authority does not go when they're sent, does not come when they're called. For instance, there are people who say they're under my authority or in this ministry, and they want my prayer to work for them. But this morning, they are not online. You call them, they don't come. You tell them go, they don't go. You realize that for a while, the devil might deceive you that you're walking in power, but you will soon get to a place where you're confronted with a major roadblock and you want to use it and then the thing does not work. You know, it's like in places where they have these cars that they use to catch thieves. And, you know, they leave the car in a place and the thief will go and open the door of the car and believes that he's smart and is driving, and they allow him to drive. But this car can be remote controlled from wherever. And the wait when the person has set off believing that, yes, I've made it. And then they'll now speak to the person, and the person will hear them through the speakers of the car that this car is this type of car, and you're a thief, you have been caught. This car will now shut down, and before the person knows what, the doors are locked, and the car parks by itself. They've got nowhere to go. Do a step or their step, and the engine is off. Nothing to do. In such a way, you cannot break out of the car. They're caught in. And so you find out that the enemy has a way to make you feel they're in control. You are progressing, you're going far. But so long as you're not a man under authority, no one can speak to you. Or you choose who should speak to you. Whereas God has put you under authority. You said to this one, it's not going. You said to this one, come, it's not coming. Just as you also, when you're instructed, you do what you want to do, when you want to do it, how you want to do it. And you know, when God places you under spiritual authority, and you live and walk like that, when those people try to help you, it is a waste of time. Because you find out that you were not submitted. When they speak to whatever is troubling your life, it will not respond. Because you are on your own. You were, driving on three engines, spiritually speaking. Just going where you want to go. In the book of 2 Corinthians 10, verse 3 to verse 6, it says, For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. And now it says, you cast down imaginations and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, and bring into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. We are constant in warfare, high things exalting themselves against the knowledge of God. But the Bible says we have been empowered to bring them into captivity. But here is a warning. He says in verse 6, and having in a readiness to revenge all disobedience. As you are doing what you're doing, you must be ready to revenge every form of disobedience. You cannot allow any form of disobedience to slip past you. You cannot afford any form of disobedience to go on its own. At the times, you know, as a leader or as a parent, you can just get tired if you have someone under you that decides to walk in serial obedience, disobedience. And you can get to the point, I have corrected, I've spoken, I'm not speaking anymore. No, the Bible says, be ready to revenge all disobedience. Okay, I'll correct this one, I'll leave it in that one. No, you must be ready to revenge all disobedience. But there's a caveat there. Very strong. It says, when your own obedience is fulfilled. If you are not an obedient Christian, don't dream that you can handle disobedience. For a little while, the demons might act as though they obey you, just so they can get you into a corner. It's just like when God showed Joshua how to deal with the people of Ai, who had killed some Israelites. And the only reason why they were able to kill those Israelites is because those Israelites walked in disobedience, walked in rebellion through the sin of Achan. And now when God was ready to give Israel victory, he showed them how to set an ambush. And then they were to act as though the enemy was overpowering them and they were fleeing. And the enemy kept on pursuing them right into the trap. And he said, when they've gone far, let the men at the back set the city on fire. And they did so. And by the time they realized that, oh, it's a trap, they wanted to turn back. It was late. They were caught in the middle. And that was the end. It's important that as you're moving on in life, check and see how you are advancing so that you're not deceived. Right now, you need to call somebody who is not subject to authority. Who my words, through my constant encouragement, get on, connect daily, and be encouraged, be built up, be strengthened in your personal life with God. And they're not doing it. Come to prayer service, they'll not come. Midweek service, they'll not come. Be consistent in church. All the authority of God's word is flouted. Do it when they want to. And I've come to a place where they explain away their disobedience and make it, you know, look as this thing is legitimate. My disobedience, my non-compliance is legitimate. It is not. Because when it comes to time for you to deal with disobedience, you will not be able to deal with disobedience. You will not be able to deal with the enemy who comes. But since you must resist the devil for him to flee from you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. You must be ready to revenge all disobedience only when your own obedience is fulfilled. That is complete obedience. Total obedience. The NIV says in 2 Corinthians 10 verse 6, it puts it this way, the New International Version, and we will be ready to punish every act of disobedience once your obedience is complete. You can only punish disobedience when your own obedience is complete. You are meant to punish disobedience. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory be to God. Now, today, as we go on, I want to deal with another dimension by which we serve as representatives of God. In Acts 10, verse 38, it says, how God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. Now, this is what the Lord Jesus Christ did. He went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil. Now, God was with him. Now, what Christ did, we are required to go about doing the same thing. He's depending on his church to represent him in setting the oppressed free. He's depending on you and I to go about setting people free from the bondages and the chains of demonic oppression, just as he did. Now, but we see how Christ Jesus entered into that life of power. The Bible says how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil. Now go to Luke 4, verse 1 and 2. We understand that Christ had submitted himself to be baptized by John the Baptist in the river Jordan. He had submitted himself to somebody's authority, to somebody to baptize him. And now we read in Luke 4, verse 1.
And Jesus, being full of the Holy Ghost, returned from Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, being 40 days tempted of the devil. And in those days he did eat nothing. And when they were ended, he afterward hungered.
Now, take note of two things you see here. There are more, but look, take note of two things. Well, maybe more. That he was full of the Holy Spirit. And he was led by the Holy Spirit. A lot of people like the part of feeling that they're filled with the Spirit. But you have to be led by the Holy Spirit. Now, so he was submitted. The Lord Jesus submitted himself to the Holy Spirit. You see, the hierarchy in the Godhead. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. But when Christ came upon the face of the earth, he came as man. And so he came and had to be submitted to the Holy Spirit to lead him. So as we're going through, you're seeing all these things connected. For him to effectively represent God upon the face of the earth, he had to submit to the Holy Spirit and then be led by the Holy Spirit. You must submit to the Holy Spirit, you must submit to authorities, and you must allow authorities to lead you. And the leading we see here, he was led by the Holy Spirit to go into the wilderness, to be tempted of the devil, 40 days and night. And in that temptation was fasting and prayer. You see, without fasting and prayer, you are weak against the devil. You're weak in resisting the devil. Listen to me. Wherever you are, give a wave. Give a wave in your home, in your car, in your office. Depending on what country you're watching from, in your bedroom. Wave to me. Wave, wave. Listen, you must understand that you cannot be strong enough against satanic and demonic attacks without fasting and prayer. The moment you realize that things you had once overcome begin to work against your life, you have got to be ready to activate strongly your fasting life. You have got to be ready to cry out to God in fasting and prayer, because that is where strength comes from. It's one place where strength comes from. Because as you fast and pray, you submit to the Holy Spirit, you feed your life with the word of God, and you are made strong. All right? But not only that, you find out that you enter into a higher level of power. You enter into a higher level of spiritual authority. When you press in to fasting and prayer, hallelujah, without fasting and prayer, you find that there's a limit to your anointing. There's a limit to where you can enter into without fasting and prayer. Glory be to God. When you seek God in fasting and prayer, when Christ obeyed the Holy Spirit and went into fasting and prayer, when you look at the book of Luke 4, the same chapter 4, verse 14, the Bible says, and Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit into Galilee. And there went out a fame of him throughout all the region around about. As we go into the year 2022, as we end 2021, we must end with power. Amen. We must go into the new year with power. Amen. Not just power for ourselves, but power that is great enough to help others also, to set the oppressed free. And that is why you must join in the fasting and prayer. When others are feasting, that was the wisdom of Elijah. Why do people fast over the end of year period, Christmas period, so called? Why do you fast? Listen, we are using the wisdom of Elijah. When Ahab went up to eat and drink, he went up the mountain and threw himself down in prayer. And that's how he gained command and authority some more. He had already been working in it, but he now showed us. This is a secret. He gave us insight because of the introduction of Elijah. We had no insight into his background. It's just that Elijah stood up and began to give command. Where did he come from? We had not seen it. But as we look through his life, we now understand the secret of Elijah. He made mention, I stand before God. I'm one that waits upon God in prayer. I'm one that calls upon God. And we saw Elijah, who said, now, hey, have you go? And he went up the mountain to eat and drink. I mean, to fast, while Ahab went to eat and drink. Then from there, he sent instruction to the king. King, get on the chariot and start running. Because otherwise, the rain about to call will block you. And the king obeyed and got on And Elijah, who was up, an elderly man on the mountain, came down and began to run, and he overtook the chariot, overtook the rider. I declare to you that as you seek God in fasting and prayer, you are going to enter into dimension. We are going to enter into a higher dimension as God's representative. Amen. We speak to natural authorities. Amen. We speak to people. Amen. We speak to forces, and they'll hear us. Amen. And they'll obey us. Amen. It is time for you to press in the spirit. Amen. It's time for you to go deeper in fasting and prayer, so you can walk in the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ. You can represent him better on earth. Hallelujah. In verse 18, the same chapter, it declares, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, and recovery of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord." This is what he has called us to do also. This is what he did. And that's why he calls us to fasting and prayer. When you go to the book of Isaiah 58, very quickly, it says from verse 5 and verse 6, "Is it such a fast that I've chosen? A day for a man to afflict his soul? Is it to bow down his head as a bulrush, and to spread sackcloth and ashes under him? Will thou call this a fast, an acceptable day to the Lord?" Now watch verse 6. "Is not this the fast that I've chosen, to loose the bands of wickedness, to undo heavy burdens, to let the oppressed go free, and that she break every yoke?" When you engage in fasting and prayer, you're empowered to be a help, to be a help to generation, to be a help to those who are in bondage. And that's why you find that for some reason, Daniel was not in the place where he could fast 40 days and 40 nights without food and water. But for 21 days, he engaged a type of fasting in which the Bible says no pleasant food came to his mouth. He didn't drink wine. So, by implication, it means he drank water. It means he maybe ate some other things. Probably like what he had done in chapter 1, when they did not eat of the king's meat and ate more of greens. He must have abandoned, something's there. Maybe no meat, no pleasant food. He could not go in the street, no water, no food. He ate something. He was serving before the king. But he made sure he ate no pleasantries. So there was a type of fasting he did in order to set Israel free. When Esther was to set Israel free, she also engaged 3 days fasting and prayer. No water, no food. Brother, I'm calling on you this morning. It's time for you to be God's representative. You must walk in power. The oppressed must come to you and be set free. Those in bondage must come to you and realize that there's power to deliver them. You must not be another ordinary, hallelujah, Christian with no power in your life. You must not be another ordinary Christian that anyone can throw around and treat as they want to treat. It's time for you to enter into the power dimension, in the supernatural dimension. It's time for it to be an answer to people. It's time for it to be solution to the lives of people. It's time for it to move out of selfishness. Jesus Christ went about doing good, healing all that were oppressed of the enemy. Pastor, it's time for it to be to plant more churches, do more good, be God's representative, go to communities. Christian, it's time for it to plant more covenant families. It's time for it to adopt more places, offices, schools. Go in and help people. It's time for you to rise up in your environment. Stop being like the crowd. You go to school, trying to dress and put makeup and put whatever. You're a different person in school from who you are at home. You're a different person at work from who you are at home. It's time for you to be God's representative and be a blessing to people. And you can do this by fasting and prayer. You submit yourself to authority and you become a man and a woman of prayer and fasting. All your life represents now, and you're so happy. You give you some financial tips here, there, and you're happy. You give them some professional help here, there. You're so happy. God has called you to more than that. It's called to be a spiritual blessing. This morning, rise to your feet. And I want you to lift your hand in prayer to Almighty God and ask God to help you to be a blessing to people. Ask God to help you. The Bible says you can only revenge disobedience, and you must revenge disobedience. And if you don't revenge disobedience, it means you are disobeying God further. But you can only do this when your own obedience is fulfilled.
I believe you've been tremendously blessed by this program with such powerful exposition of God's Word. Join the Living Word of Faith Outreach Ministries International in our next broadcast. Also join us in worship at the Faith Cathedral 5 and 7 Victoria Street in Freetown on Sundays at 7 and 9 a.m. and Thursdays at 6 p.m. For prayers, counseling and testimony, please call +232 309007 or +232 77 853 207 or +232 77 858 1. This is the Living Word of Faith Outreach Ministries International.